Hey, I made the IT nerdy list this year. I knew that. Let's see what they got going on here. Holy crap, a UniFi modem.
Take my money. Now it's a good thing I did same minute shipping. It should be here any second. So let's just hurry up and wait with some new merch. My favorite piece of merch is actually this water bottle. I think they're here. It's here. And the water bottle is perfectly fine. Let's crack this open. Ooh, rack mounts. Got the screws and feet. Who needs that? Box with the power cord. So here is the modem, and it has a level. Check that out. We've got the coax here on the back. Nice little screen on the front, and the power cord actually locks into the unit. Pretty handy. Let me call my ISP and get this set up. So I called up Cox, and this is the first UCI modem that he's ever seen. Now both the serial number as well as the MAC address are exactly the same. Now this modem is so new, he had to use an old system to manually input it because the new system wasn't taking it, even though it showed up as an available option. Now what's interesting is that the modem does not get the IP address of the 192.168.100.1 like most do. And initially here, when I logged in locally, it did not show cable internet here for me to adopt. After the modem was reprovisioned by my ISP, it did a couple of reboots and now it's ready to adopt. So I'm clicking adopt.
A few moments later.
Looks like it is adopted and there's already an update. Confirm that. During the firmware update, the UISP strip actually rebooted the modem. Luckily it came up fine and it didn't brick it, because that would have sucked. And even after it came back up, it kept saying that it was updating for a really long time. Now I jump back over to the UniFi dashboard, and I came in and I renamed my modem after my new product line. We also have tea as well if you don't like coffee. Now, under overview, it just gives us if it's gig or 2.5 gig, the MAC address, the device version, and the uptime. And here it shows us how much bandwidth is going out to the internet. We click on insights, there's not really a lot here. Go to clients, again, nothing. And settings, here you can just rename it to what you want. You can locate, restart, remove. That's just about it. Although you can change the night mode settings for the little LCD screen in case this is like in your bedroom instead of a home office.
So who is this for? Well, if you have a home lab like I do, then having something like this is very sleek and it just fits right in with the rest of your networking infrastructure if it's UniFi based. And also future promise of more telemetry into the modem and its signals in the UniFi dashboard if and when that happens, hopefully in the first quarter of 2024. Now since I have switched over to this modem, I have had less disconnects and drops from my ISP. But without access to the signal data, I can't really tell you why it is more stable, because both it and the previous modem were on conditioned battery backed up power. So unless my ISP damaged my modem, I don't know. So what are some of your thoughts on why the UCI would be more stable than a Aeris SB8200?
Now click over here if you want to check out the UDR versus UDM, or check out over here with the UDM Pro versus the UDM Pro SE.